Can you take your Bibles and turn to the book of St. Mark? St. Mark chapter 12. And we're going to read from verses 14 to verse 17. Hallelujah. St. Mark chapter 12 from verses 14 to 17. And I'll read. And when they were come, they say unto him, Master, we know that thou art true and carest for no man, for thou regardest not the person of men, but teachest the way of God in truth. Is it lawful to give tribute to Caesar or not? Shall we give or shall we not give? But he, knowing their hypocrisy, said unto them, Why tempt ye me? Bring me a penny that I may see it. And they brought it, and he said unto them, Whose is this image and superscription? And they said unto him, Caesar's. And Jesus answering said unto them, Render to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and to God the things that are God's. And they marveled at him. Hallelujah. And I'm going to be taking my text from verse 17. And Jesus answering said unto them, Render to Caesar the things that are Caesar, and unto God the things that are God. And this morning, before I go any further, I first want to tell you who Caesar is and what Caesar represents. And Caesar was a Roman emperor. And this represents authority. This represents government. This represents dominion. And this represents control. And this morning, Caesar is taking a lot from us. And God is not pleased with us this morning, because Caesar is getting most of the stuff and God is getting nothing. And the Holy Spirit is saying unto us, render to Caesar the things that are Caesar's. The Pharisees knew what Jesus was teaching in the temple. But the scripture went to say they wanted to tempt God. They thought they could trip God up. They didn't even know who they were speaking to. But Jesus was the greatest teacher. They referred to him as Rabbi. So he knew what they were thinking. And he had the answer for them. He said, bring the penny for me now. Bring the penny for me. He said, look at it. Whose name is on the penny? Whose superscription is on the penny? Whose face can you see on the penny? They said, Rabbi, we see Caesar's on the penny. Well, give to Caesar what is Caesar, and give unto God what is God. So, but Rabbi, what you mean? What to give to Caesar? The poll tax. Caesar sent an order out that everyone was supposed to pay tax. And I think they were trying to get around it and trying to find out what Jesus was thinking. But Jesus was saying, give to Caesar that which is Caesar's, and give unto God that which is God's. So now we all have to give Caesar our tax and everything. But what Jesus is saying this morning, that this is the scale, and this is Caesar over here weighing down, taking everything, and God is up here. God is getting just the drainage. And it's just like we are all Caribbean people, and I think so. Anyway, you'll understand what I'm saying. When we used to make lemonade, this is how simple I want to bring it down, because even the children, I want you to understand what I'm saying. When we used to make lemonade, we used to make it with brown sugar. When we mix the lemonade with brown sugar, we don't float everything out of the mug. We float, and then we leave the bottom of the mug, because it's dregs. We call it dregs. It's dusty, and it will choke you. So you can't drink it. This is what we're leaving for Jesus, the dregs. We're leaving him the dregs. We're not giving him what we're supposed to give him today. We had a lovely youth service. I honor the youths. I'm glad for the youths. What I'm saying this morning, render to Caesar the things which are Caesar, and unto God the things that are God's. So back to what I'm saying now. So everything we give unto Caesar. We give Caesar our time. We give him our money. Anything that Caesar tells us to do, we do it. Who is Caesar today? The government. Look on the penny that you have in your pocket and you'll see who is on it. So we are talking about the British government at this time. And everything they tell us to do, we're going to do it. and we do it fervently. If we have an appointment at the job center, or if we have something at the school to do, school starts at 9, we're going to get there for 9. The job center say come for 1 o'clock. If we even have to push down all people to get there, we're going to push them down just to get there. Because when they call your name, you want to be there seated. When they say Sister Pearl, they will say Pearl in Mays, and you want to be there to come to get what is for you. And they don't want no excuse. You can't say the train was late. They're going to tell you, leave time. You know this is a busy place and you have to leave time, so you should have left earlier. So what I'm trying to say is we do everything that we can. We do our best. Everything we do, we give it our best. We're going to school, we give it our best. That is good. It's good to put in 101% in your schoolwork, because education is important. But the things of God requires haste. It says the king's business requires haste. And we have to study the word of God, read the word of God in our little secret place, going to prayer in our little prayer closet, and speak our own way. We are not too young to speak to God, and we are not too old to speak to God. And young people, the Lord knows everything about you this morning. He knows the peer pressure. He knows the pain. He knows the hormone imbalance. He knows everything, because he created you. He knows when you're up. He knows when you're down. He knows when you're in. He knows when you're out. But this morning, God is saying to you, I'm concerned about you. Yes, give to Caesar what you know Caesar is due. Give Caesar. Go to school, get your education. Go down the road, have a good time. Nobody tell you to lock away in the house. But when it comes to the things of God require priority. And we have to give unto God what is due unto God. And we have to give unto Caesar what is due unto Caesar. So I'm not telling you to be disrespectful this morning. I'm not telling you to go into your classroom and tell the teacher what you like. Because this is the word of God saying, render to Caesar what is Caesar's. And the things unto God, you have to render to God. So when you go to the classroom and things are not going your way, thank you. When you go into the classroom and things are not going your way, nobody says you have to bow. There's a line you have to draw. You don't have to bow. They put Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the fire. But they came out without even smelling of the fire. This is the God that we serve. If you stand up for God, he's going to stand up for you this morning. Give unto Caesar what is Caesar's, and give unto God what is God's. And you may be saying in your seat, well, what can I do? What can I give unto God? But all of us are special, and we have a destiny. We have a great destiny, and God is interested in us. And in Jeremiah, he said that the thoughts that I have for you are of good and not of evil, and to give thee an expected end. So God knows all about us this morning. God is concerned about all of us this morning. He hasn't forgotten about us this morning. But this morning we have to be fear. We have to be fear this morning, and we have to give unto Caesar that which is Caesar's, and give unto God that which is God's. And then we're going to start giving with our tithes and our little offering. Malachi chapter 3 verse 10 says, bring all your tithes into the storehouse and prove me now. Prove God now. Don't let Caesar take God's portion. I know it is hard. I know things are expensive. And I know sometimes after the tax comes out, the income tax comes out, nothing much is left, and sometimes we're in two minds. Wonder if we should give God. Wonder if I shouldn't give God. Wonder if I should give God. Wonder if I shouldn't give God. But you gave it to Caesar. Caesar took his portion. So when you know that Caesar has taken his portion, give God his portion. And even the little children, when you get a little pound, or when you get your little pocket money, you could leave something out, if it's a 25 pence, any little thing, leave it out, and don't just go running to the shop and spending it all at once. You leave this and you say, when I go to church on Sunday, I'm going to give this offering unto God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So don't forget, when you get your little pocket money, Don't go to the shop and you have a pound and buy something for a pound, because nothing is going to be left. So you work out and you buy something less than a pound, so you have something left to take to the house of God. And you cannot lose. You cannot lose, because the scripture said he will rebuke the devourer. You understand? God is going to take sickness away from us. Disease and famine is a recession, but even though recession is going on, God is going to provide for us. He will not leave us desolate. He will make a way for us, even in the dark desert, even out there in the desert, and you think that all hope is gone and nothing is left. God will make a way. Bring the tithes into the storehouse and prove me now, said the Lord of hosts. And this morning we have to plant something to get something. We have to plant. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Isn't God worthy? Isn't God worthy? We have to plant seeds this morning. We have to sow seeds this morning. We have to give God something to work with. Give God something to work with. David said, I will not give unto God that which costs me nothing. And sometimes nobody knows what it costs us. Nobody knows. Nobody knows, but God knows. And God knows our name this morning. He knows our thoughts this morning. And God will make a way where there seems to be no way. So anything the scripture here is saying, nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible once you put God first. Render to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and render to God the things that are God's. And let me tell you something this morning. Caesar has its limitations. Caesar has his limitations. Caesar will promise you this, Caesar will promise you that, but Caesar is limited. Caesar is limited. There's a higher power. There's a higher government. Because in the scripture, in Isaiah, he said, the government shall be upon his shoulders. He shall be called counselor. Ha talabo shedde. He talabo shi andalabo shanda. Yendalabo shin talabo shanda. E kelabo shendalabo sha. E yalabo shata. Render to Caesar. He kalabo shi. E labo shende. The things that are Caesar's. And render to God the things that are God's. God is concerned about us this morning. Hallelujah. God is concerned about us this morning. Yes, we have problems. Yes, we have troubles. But put it into God's hand. Give to Caesar what is Caesar's. Give unto God what is God. God is not asking nothing impossible this morning. Anything he's asking, he already knows. He already knows. He has made a way. Prove him. Prove him. God, I'm weary. God, I'm weary. Nobody knows. Nobody knows. I'm tired. I have pains. I have hate. I have mental problem. I'm depressed, Lord. Oh, God, nobody knows. Nobody sees. But God sees. Tell it to Jesus. Tell it to Jesus. Tell it to Jesus. He's a friend that's well known. He knows everything. He knows everything. He's concerned. He's concerned about us this morning. Caesar has his limitations. Take the limitation after God this morning. Take the limitation after God this morning. Prove him this morning. Prove him this morning. God is not like man. God is not my man. If he said he will do it, he will do it. If he said he will do it, he will do it. Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again. That which is born of the flesh is flesh. That which is born of the spirit is spirit. But one thing I'm telling you this morning, ye must be born again. You must be born again. You must be born again. Come as you are. Come as you are. Jesus sees. Jesus knows. But I'm telling you this morning, Caesar has its limitations. He cannot save your soul on that judgment day. He cannot save your soul on that judgment day. I'm telling you now, Caesar cannot save your soul. Yes, give to Caesar what is Caesar's, but don't forget, you have to give to God that is God's. So we're going to go and we're going to sow good seeds. What can I sow this morning? What can I render? What can I render to the Lord for all his benefits to me? What can I render? What can I give? What can I give? What gift can I bring to the Lord this morning? What can I bring to God this morning? Oh, glory, what can I bring? What can I bring? What can I bring? You may be saying, What can I bring? Oh, Atalaboshende. Caesar has taken all. Oh, you don't know. You don't know. Caesar has taken all. But this morning we bind Caesar. We bind principalities. We bind spiritual wickedness in high places. We bind up Caesar this morning because Caesar has God's people backed in a corner. Every time we try to do good, evil keeps presenting itself. But this morning I'm telling Caesar, you take your place. You take your place. You take your place and let God take his place. Let God take his place. God is high and lifted up. High and lifted up. Higher than Caesar, higher than any government. And this morning, Caesar will tell you, if you give this to me, I'll give this to you. But news flash, Caesar is a liar. Caesar is a liar, and the truth is not in him this morning. Caesar will lure you in. This is the government system, a Babylonian system that will lure you in, tell you, come here, come there, come get this, come get that. Sometimes you even lose your soul. You even sell out your soul in the process. But Jesus is saying this morning, give me what is for me. Give Caesar what is for Caesar's. Don't give me no dregs. I don't want no dregs this morning. Hey, tell about Shende. Come as you are. Just as you are. Come as you are. Because the blood will never lose its power. I said the blood will never lose its power. God is above Caesar this morning. God is above Caesar this morning. Sometimes we get so scared and we buckle. We buckle, we look on the news. Oh, Caesar, bring in this. Caesar, bring in that. What are we going to do now? What are we going to do? But Daniel said, I'm not going to shut my mouth. Open the window. Open the window and I'm going to pray. And they could not shut Daniel's mouth. And Daniel prayed. Oh, Daniel prayed. Daniel prayed. He prayed, he prayed, he prayed. And God delivered him. God delivered him from the hands of Caesar. And this morning I'm telling you that God will deliver you. Stand for Jesus. Stand for Jesus, because that's what matters today. Stand for Jesus. Stand for Jesus, because at the end of the day, it's your soul. It's your soul that matters. It's not what you can get. It's not what you can get this morning, but it's what you can give to God this morning. And when you give, God will give back to you. Press down. Shake on together, running over this morning. And you may say, sister, what you're talking about? Sister, what you're talking about? I've given everything. From a youth, I've served God, and look at me. Look at me, but God sees. God is behind of the scenes, and God is working overtime on your behalf. And this morning, I'm going to tell you, any seed, any good seed that you have sown, it will grow. It will germinate, and it will bring forth fruit in its season. And his leaves shall not wither. And whatsoever you doeth this morning shall prosper. You shall prosper this morning. It doesn't matter what the outcasts, how we look this morning. It doesn't matter what the media is saying, that this is failing, this is shutting down, that is shutting down. Hold on to God. Give unto Caesar that which is Caesar's. And give unto God that which is God's. Prove God. Prove God. Young people, learn your lesson well. Study your work. Come out successful, be the best that you can be. But don't forget God. In the midst of your studies, remember that God who has you, he has you in the palm of his hands. And he's the one that's going to bring you out. He's going to bring you out all right. And this morning, we love the Lord. We love the Lord, and we won't take it back this morning, because he has been so good. He has been so good. When Caesar has written this off, sometimes the system writes off people. That's why so many of us are messed up. Because the system labels us and tells us who we are. But God is saying this morning, the thoughts that I have for you are of good and not of evil. And to give thee an expected end this morning. It doesn't matter what the doctor said this morning. It doesn't matter what the teacher says this morning. God stands. His government stands. His government rules. His government reigns this morning. And I'm telling you, put your trust in God. Put your hand in God. Because he will not leave you. He will not make you ashamed. He will not make you ashamed. Don't worry about how it looks now. God is on the case. God is on the throne. And he will remember his own. His promise is true. And he will not forget you. God is still on the throne. And this morning I'm telling you, put your hands into God's hand. He's not sleeping. He's not sleeping. He's on the case. He may be slow, but he's coming through. he's coming through. Rest in his arms. Don't rest in the arms of Caesar. Caesar is going to fail you this morning. Caesar is going to leave you desolate this morning. This morning, Caesar said this. Tonight, Caesar changed his mind. Caesar said, oh, sorry, when we look at the books, we have to go this way. We have to go that way. But I'm telling you, this word will stand. This word will stand. And heaven and earth may pass away, but this word, you can bank on it. You can bank on it this morning. And God has not forgotten any of us this morning. And God knows where we are this morning. He knows the pains. He knows the suffering. But God is saying, bring it to me. Bring it to me. Don't take it to Caesar. You've given it to Caesar. Caesar is not delivering. But this morning I'm going to deliver. I'm going to come forth. I'm going to bring you through. And when I bring you through, you're going to be a wonder. When I bring you through, you're going to be the talk of the town. When I bring you through, you're going to be a marvel. People are going to want to know if this is sister, this is the brother that I saw walking like that. But I'm telling you, if God be God, serve him this morning. Render to Caesar the things that are Caesar's. And render to God the things that are God's. And I'm telling you, you will not lose. I'm telling you, you cannot lose. You cannot lose with God. You cannot lose with God. And what Caesar is doing. What Caesar is doing this morning, he's trying to blind our eyes. He's putting scales over our eyes. So he's trying to make evil look good. And he's trying to glorify it. And if you're not careful, even the very elect. Even the very elect will be deceived. So this morning I'm saying, read the word of God for yourself. Read the word, study to show thyself approved. Rightly dividing the word of truth this morning. And I'm telling you, God could break down this word. Sometimes this word seems difficult to understand. But I'm telling you, God could break it down for you into simplified form. Right down to the least that even a baby could understand it. Because the Holy Spirit is the greatest teacher this morning. And I'm telling you, lean on Jesus. Don't lean on the arms of Caesar. Caesar is going to leave you. Because Caesar himself needs help this morning. But I'm telling you, God is able. God is able. And that which he said he will do, he will do. And I'm telling you this morning, don't second guess God. Don't second guess God. Stand on his promises. Stand on his promises. If he said he's going to do it, he's going to do it. Because he's not a man that should lie. He's not a man that should lie. I'm telling you this morning, God has not forgotten you. Wherever you are this morning, God remembered you. He remembers your name. He knows the seed that you have sowed. And he's going to bring everything that he promised to pass in his own time. But this morning, as I said, don't lean on Caesar. Stop giving God the dregs. Stop giving God what's left at the bottom of the mug. What you don't want. Stop it. God is not pleased this morning. God wants our best. God wants our best. Caesar is getting it, so we have to give God. We have to give God what is rightly his. And we don't want nobody pushing us. We don't want nobody forcing us. Because the spirit in you will tell you, give this to God because God deserves it. God deserves it. He deserves all the glory. He deserves all the honor. And he deserves all the praise. I'm telling you this morning, he deserves it. He knows everything. And he's not going to leave us desolate this morning. So the problems that we are faced with, they're not too big for him. We go into the counselor. The counselor can't help us. The counselor has his limitations. Nothing is wrong with the counselor. Nothing is wrong with seeking counsel. But there's a higher counsel. There's a higher calling which is in Christ Jesus. And let us seek him. Because he will send deliverance. He will send deliverance. And then you might be saying, so why should I? Why should I give to Caesar? Why should I give to Caesar and still give to God? Can't you see Caesar has taken everything? Can't you see? But I'm telling you what the word of God says. Render to Caesar the things that are Caesar's. And render to God the things that are God. So this morning I'm telling you, you will not be disappointed. You will not be disappointed and sow good seeds. Because the Bible said, God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, that shall ye also reap. So you have to do your planting. You have to do your planting. The word of God said, the harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. Amen. And you may be saying, but I don't know what to give. I don't know, everything I do, it just keeps coming back at me. I'm trying all my best. I'm trying to be a good girl. I'm trying to be a good boy. And when I go to school, nobody knows what I'm facing. Nobody knows the troubles, but God sees. And God knows. And I'm telling you this morning, stand up for Jesus. Stand up and stand up strong. I know the peer pressure is out there. I know this is out there. I know the billboards are out there. I know the TV is out there. Everything out there is out there. But I'm telling you, if you give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and you give to God what belongs to God, I'm telling you, God will make a way for you. God will make a way for you. But the problem comes in when we forget who God is. That is where the problem comes in. When we forget who God is and put Caesar high on the pinnacle and put God low down. God is not a doormat this morning. God is not the doormat this morning. He's the King of Kings. He's excellent. He's high and lifted up. And this morning, God, he loves us. He loves us. And he said, he loves, he chastened us this morning. And he's speaking to us in love this morning. Because he wants to take us to our destiny. And if he wants to take us to our destiny, we have to be in the right place at the right time. And we can't keep sitting the same exam year in, year out. We need to show some level of maturity. We can't drink milk this morning and drink milk next year. Still you saved this morning and 10 years you're still the same baby. It can't work. Yield yourself to God. Because somebody said, God don't have no grandchildren. What he has for one, he has for all. So I'm telling you, if you throw your all on Jesus this morning, he will make the way. He will open your eyes. He will open your eyes because some of our eyes have been blinded. But it's not too late. It's not too late because Caesar has infiltrated good. He has infiltrated good and come in with the evil. And some of us don't know wrong from right anymore. Some of us can't tell left from right, never mind right from wrong. But this morning I'm saying, oh God, have mercy on us. Have mercy on us this morning. Oh, have mercy on us this morning, Lord. Because we are willing. But every time we want to do good, evil keeps presenting itself. But God is on the case this morning. If you just render to Caesar the things that are Caesar, and render to God the things that are God, he will bring you to an expected end. He will bring you to that expected end. And there's a parable in this same chapter where this rich man was having a wedding. And he went out and he sent his servants to invite all sorts of people to the wedding. And everybody had an excuse. Somebody had land to tend to. Somebody had to go look after some servants. Somebody had business to do. I think it's Matthew. It's the same Mark further up in the chapter. Yes, Mark from verse 12. Chapter 12 from verses 1. Go right down to verse 11. Yes, and everybody had an excuse. And the rich man got upset and he said, you know what I'm going to do? He told his servants, just go out in the streets and just give the invitation. Whosoever will may come. And this is what the Lord is saying to us this morning. We have to be in the spirit of readiness. We have to be in the spirit of readiness. Because in the twinkling of an eye, we don't know the hour. We don't know the hour, so we have to be always ready. So if you think that God is going to wait on you, we have to think again. Because all those big, big people, high society people, they were the ones who got the invitation. But they were busy. So the king said, we can't have a wedding without guests. Go out on the street and bring the men in. But you have to have on that wedding garment. Put the wedding garment on. Because if you don't have on that wedding garment, you'll be left behind. Because somebody came in and his attire was out of order. And the king said, bind him and throw him into utter darkness. So God is saying this morning, I'm not going to bind any of you. I'm going to loose you today. I'm going to loose the grips of Caesar from you today. Caesar has gripped your mind. Caesar has taken over your mind, but I want to loose you this morning. I want to loose this stronghold after you this morning. And God is ready. He's ready to loose the stronghold of Caesar because God will have and God must have the final say. God bless you.